So I was driving my girls to school today, and on my way home, I start thinking about what kind of video am I going to make today? And this video opinion piece popped into my head that I had saw about 2 weeks ago. It was on the New York Times site online. And this guy was talking about the return of funk, or that's what the subject was about. And I was like, oh, what is this, some new James Brown thing or something? And it was about the Jonas Brothers, the song Sucker. And I thought, what? So I watched the thing, and this guy says one of the most ludicrous things. Let's check it out.
There's a moment, a minute and 55 seconds into the hit song by the Jonas Brothers, Sucker, that gets me every time. The track breaks down to just two instruments, a whistled melody and a drum break of stupefyingly funky proportions.
Okay, let's check this out. Okay, he calls this a drum break of stupefyingly funky proportions. Now, when I hear it, the first time I'm listening to it, I'm like, well, that's totally quantized. So I take that clip of the drum break, I put it in Pro Tools, and I take out my trusty BPM app, which is a live BPM thing that's gonna tell you the tempo right now. Okay. So the BPM is 138. The little variation that's happening is because of the other things, the whistling that's going on. But the BPM is dead on at 138. Let's actually look at it in Pro Tools. Already I can tell that it's right on grid. As a matter of fact, I'm about to turn the click on and you can hear it. Listen. The fact that it's exactly on the grid means that it's been quantized. Let me cut up the audio and show you what I mean by quantize. So we have a grid here that's set to 138 BPMs, right? So if I go past this right over to here, I take out this tempo marking and I look at it, you'll see that I've cut each of the beats right here so that you can see where all the strong beats are here. Turn off the click. Now, let's say change the tempo. I'm gonna hit tempo button, put this right here, hit tempo. Let's say go to 120. You see there's a little gap between the audio files, but listen to the click track though. You can still tell that it's perfectly in tempo. Why? Because it's been quantized. Let's change the tempo again. Let's go down to 90. 90 is very slow. There's a lot of space between beats, but listen. Works perfectly, right? Let's go to a tempo faster than 138. Let's see 150. It scrunches everything together. Listen. Okay, so the song has obviously been quantized. Can a quantized song really be funky? I mean, it's essentially been turned into a drum machine. Let's check out some more of what Nate Sloan, the professor in the New York Times article, says about the track.
These 14 seconds are like opening a wormhole through musical space-time, tying the track's drummer, Homer Steinweiss, all the way back to Clyde Stubblefield, James Brown's legendary funky drummer.
Okay, let's see what the app has to say about the tempo of funky drummer. Okay, it's basically 100, but fluctuating a little bit. Let's put it in the computer at 100 and see what happens. I have the click on, but it's getting way off the click. If I zoom in on it, so you can see where the click starts, and some of you will say, oh, you got the wrong tempo here. You know, well, look, it starts right on the beat here. This is beat one. You can see that the the kick drum's getting behind there, the snare's behind, this is behind, but then we're back on here with a kick. And then this snare drum's ahead of the beat right here. You can see this. There's the grid line. This is ahead. If I subdivide it even more here, you'll see all the grid lines. See, that's kind of ahead of the beat. That's ahead. That's ahead. Some of you might be thinking, well, 100's not the right tempo. 101's the right tempo. Well, let's take a look at 101. You'll notice that at 101, it's even more off. Look at the grid lines. You can see it getting more behind, and then eventually here, it catches back up on the snare hit. Another thing about Funky Drummer is that the beginning tempo so it's climbing.
Cut out the lights.
Oh, it's getting faster. One of the reasons that it's getting faster is that it's not played by a machine. And as you remember, the drum breaks at 100 BPM. So it's actually slowed down from the beginning of the song to that drum break 20 BPMs. That's pretty mind-boggling. But that's because it's funky. So being funky is actually not about sounding like a machine and having perfect time. It's actually being funky. Let's listen to some more of what the professor says.
Then and now, it's all about innovative syncopation, placing rhythmic accents in between the underlying beats of a song's meter. This generates an undeniable propulsive energy.
Actually, undeniable propulsive energy in the James Brown instance is the tempo fluctuating because the drummer, Clyde Stubblefield, is grooving. But in the Jonas Brothers, since it's been quantized, it doesn't really have propulsive energy. It stays static because that's what quantizing does. Now, I'm sure that Homer Steinweiss's drum part was funky before they fixed it. That's all for now. Please leave your comments in the comments section. I'd love to know what you think. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe now. If you're a new viewer, don't forget to ring the bell. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. You can find it there. Check out the new Beato ear training method that just was released a couple weeks ago. Go to the website, watch the intro video at BeatoEarTraining.com. Follow me on Instagram at RickBeato1. And if you want to support the channel even more, think about becoming a member of the Beato Club. Thanks for watching.